Hello everyone, this is Nishit Desai and today we will be learning about a new subject, that is cloud structure. As the name suggests, this subject will deal with the structure and the pattern of the fabric. So let us start. Previously, we have learned about the weaving process, that it is the process of interlacement of warp and weft threads. So here, a weave gives the pattern in which the warp and the weft yarns will be interlaced. The weave influences the aesthetics of the fabric and as well as some of the properties of the fabric. Now, let us see, while marking a design, how to denote the movement of the threads. Let us consider this as the fabric. The vertical threads are the warp and the horizontal threads are the weft threads. And for easy understanding, below the circles denote the warp threads and the wavy yarn is the weft thread. Now let us see how to denote this. Let us make a table first. Now just focus on the movement of the first warp thread. We can see that it is moving over the first weft. Whenever a warp is above the weft, we mark it with a cross. And whenever the weft is above the warp, we leave it blank. So the first warp is moving above the first weft. So we will mark it with a cross. Now, it moves below the weft, so we will leave a blank space. Again, it moves above the weft thread, so we will mark a cross. Now, again it moves below, so we leave a blank and then again cross. This was the movement of the first warp. Now for the second warp. It is moving below the first weft, so we will leave blank. Then it passes over the weft, so we will mark it with a cross. Again it moves down. So we will leave a blank, then cross, blank, and cross. This was the movement for the second warp. So this is how we denote the movement. You mark a cross wherever the warp is up, and you leave a blank wherever the weft is up. Now let us learn about the most basic fabric, that is the plain weave. This weave has a one up one down structure. Let us see what this means. First, let us create a table and mark the rows and the columns. Here, the columns denote the warp threads and the rows denote the weft threads. Now, as we know, it has a one up one down structure, which means that for every alternate pick, the warp passes above and below it. Now just focus on the first warp thread. We will mark a cross because it passes over the weft. For the second pick, we will leave it blank. For the third pick, we will again mark a cross. Fourth pick, we will leave blank. And for the fifth pick, again we will mark a cross. And for the sixth pick, we'll again leave it blank. Now, let us focus on the second warp thread. The first warp thread was lifted for the first pick. So here, for the first pick, the second warp will be below it. We will start with a blank space. For the second pick, it will pass over it. So we will mark a cross. Similarly, it will follow the movement of one down and one up. For the third warp, the movement will be the same as the first warp. And for the fourth warp, it will be same as the second warp. Fifth and the sixth warp will also be the same as the first and the second warp respectively. So this is how a plain weave is marked. This is known as the design of the fabric. Now we have all come across the term repeat size. So what does this repeat size mean? Basically, it is the motif or the smallest way in which the design can be represented. For example, for this design, if you focus on the highlighted part and look closely, you will see that the same design or the same highlighted part gets repeated all over the design. Therefore, this is the repeat size of the design, or this weave can be represented with this motif. Hence, we can say that the plain weave has a repeat size of 2n's. Up till now, we have seen what is a design. Now let us take the same design and see the other components which are important while marking the design. Now we need to mark a draft. A draft basically shows us that which ends will be passed through which heel frame. It also gives us the number of heel frames to be used. Here, let us mark the first warp passing through the first heel frame. So we denote it with a cross. For the second warp, the movement is different than the first warp, and therefore we will pass it through the second heel frame. Now, for the third and the fifth warp, the movement is same as the first warp. Therefore, it will pass through the same heel as the first warp, that is the first heel frame. And for the 4th and the 6th warp thread, the lifting and the lowering is the same as the second warp thread. Therefore, it will pass through the same heel frame as the second warp, that is the second heel frame. So here, we can see that we have marked the draft and two heel frames are being used. The next component is the pec plan or the lifting plan. Till now, we have marked the design. We know which end passes through which heel frame by using the draft. Now this pec plan or the lifting plan shows us the order in which the heel frames need to be lifted or lowered. So let us see for the first heel frame. We will mark an arrow and focus on the movement of the thread passing through the first heel frame. That will be the movement of the particular heel frame. First, third, and the fifth ends are passing through the first heel. So we will mark these with the same movement. Similarly, for the second heel frame, the second, fourth, and the sixth ends are passing through the same heel. So we will mark that movement. This is how a pec plan is marked. These three components are very important while marking a design. Now, let us study about the ornamentation of plain weave. Ornamentation basically means decoration. So in ornamentation, we change the appearance or pattern by changing the parameters, but the weave structure remains the same. We can change the parameters like using yarn with different counts, that is coarser counts or finer counts, variation in crimp percentage, yarn with different tensions, warp of different color, weft of different color, or stripes or checks patterns with different colors. Different material for warp and different material for weft. Variations in twist levels for warp threads to produce a crepe kind of effect. These are some of the ways in which the ornamentation of plain weave is done. There are many more effects that can be produced. Now, let us see some derivatives of plain weave. These are produced by changing the structure of the weave. The derivatives of plain weave are warp rib structure, weft rib structure, or mat and basket weave. Let us first see the warp rib structure. We will mark a 2-up, 2-down warp rib structure. Now let us focus on the first warp thread. For the first pick, the warp will be up. For the second pick also, it will be up. For the third and the fourth pick, the warp will be below the pick. Now for the second warp. For the first pick, the warp will be down. Similarly, for the second also, it will be down. And for the third and the fourth pick, it will be up. We will mark the draft and pec plan as we have already studied how to mark it. Now, as you all can see in the diagram, the strands or the ribs can be seen in the warp direction. This is the effect that is produced in the warp rib structure. Now, let us study the weft rib structure. Here, we will mark the first and the second end passing over the first pick and passing below the second pick. And the third and the fourth end passing below the first pick and above the second pick. Now we will mark the draft and the pec plan. So in the diagram, you can see that strands or ribs can be seen in the weft direction. This is the pattern that is produced in the weft rib structure. Now, let us see the last derivative, that is the mat or the basket weave. We will see the 2x2 mat weave structure. Here, the first end passes in 2-up 2-down order. Similarly, for the second warp. For the third warp, it passes in 2-down 2-up order. And similarly, for the fourth end. Now, let us mark the draft. First and the second warp have the same lifting order, so they will pass through the same heel frame. Third and the fifth warp have the same lifting order, so they will also pass through the same heel frame. And now we will mark the peg plan. In the image besides, you can see how a mat or a basket weave look. So this was all from the first part of the cloth structure. Stay tuned with us, we will be coming up with the other parts shortly. If y'all have any doubts, please mention them in the comments box below. Like this video, share it with all the textile people you know, and do subscribe to TexConnect, a learning center for textiles. Stay tuned, thank you.